Hey there, survivors. Cougar here with a beginner's guide to combat in Ancestors. The most important thing to know about combat as a beginner is that your primates don't know how to fight yet. So combat starts out very difficult, but gets much, much easier as your primates gain XP and learn some combat skills. And the way they're going to learn those skills is to keep trying and failing. You must be prepared to try and fail a few times in order to teach your primates how to fight more effectively. You may get injured in the process, but I'll talk a little bit about injury remedies at the end of the vid. Knowing these ahead of time, or even applying them ahead of time as preventive medicines, will help you avoid frustration as a beginner. So, on to game mechanics. Ancestors uses an action on release control scheme. So every fight consists of holding down the action button, then holding down a direction, then releasing the action button when you hear a click chime sound. Use the direction toward the opponent if you want to attack, or a direction left, right, or backward to dodge. And this is very important, so pay attention to this. As a beginner, there's a chance that you never hear that click chime sound. Your primates simply may not have the skills yet to allow them to have even a chance of succeeding in combat. You may have to try and fail a couple of times before you hear that sound, so just be prepared for that. Looking at some weapons here. Any stick, stone, or bone club is an effective defensive weapon. You can protect yourself from injury and potentially scare off the predator with even an unstripped stick or an unaltered rock. So here we have an unstripped stick, a stripped stick, a sharpened stick, and a plain stone, and a stone that's been refined into a basalt chopper, and a bone club. Any of these will deter a predator, but your chances of killing a predator go up with each alteration. A stripped stick has a better chance of killing than an unstripped stick. A sharpened stick has a better chance of killing than a stripped stick. And a refined rock has a better chance of killing than an unrefined rock. A bone club has a relatively low chance of killing anything, but it will never break or degrade. If you're holding one weapon when you're attacked, it does not matter which hand the weapon is in. Your primate will defend themselves regardless. If you're holding a weapon in each hand, say a sharpened stick in one hand and a rock in the other hand, your primate will use whatever it's in its right hand first. So if you're going for a kill, make sure the sharpened stick is in your right hand. If you're just looking to defend yourself, the rock can be in your right hand. Before we get into combat, I want to talk for a second about intimidation. If you don't want to get into a fight, you can always try to intimidate your opponent by standing up and shouting at them before you start fighting. Intimidation is a very important skill to develop over time, so make sure that you are at least trying to intimidate opponents a lot to gain that XP and learn those skills, while at the same time being prepared to fight or dodge if the intimidation does not work. Okay, so let's get into some combat here. The easiest opponents for a beginner are snakes. They're easy to intimidate, easy to dodge, and pretty easy to kill. All predators have the same behavior in combat, so once you've learned how to fight a snake, you can fight anything. Except hippos and elephants. You don't actually want to fight those. Dodging is the way to go for hippos and elephants. An important note on dodging here. There's a very good chance, especially at the very start, that you will drop whatever you're holding when you dodge. But you can gain skills to eventually lower the chance that you drop your weapon when you dodge. Plus, you get evolutionary feat bonus XP from dodging every different type of animal in the game. So keep dodging. Keep intimidating, gain those XP points, build those skills. Let's talk quickly about medicines and remedies. Kapok fibers found in trees, a stripped horsetail plant found near water, and aloe found in the savanna biome will stop bleeding. Bleeding is usually caused by a big cat or hyena attack. Using a granite grinder tool, you can also mash up stripped horsetail fibers and aloe into a paste, which is much more effective at preventing bleeding. You can apply all of these pastes and all of these medicines preventively ahead of time if you know you're going into combat and want some protection from bleeding. Same for eating horsetails and cot leaves. Both will help repair broken bones and prevent broken bones if used proactively. Using a granite grinder tool to mash up cot leaves into a paste provides maximum broken bone and cold protection. Broken bones are usually caused by non-predators like warthogs or hippos. Snake venom can be cured or prevented by eating snails, honey, or coconuts, or it'll be removed simply by drinking a lot of water. Before I let you go, let me leave you with one tip. I usually travel with one stick and one rock equipped. This way, if you lose your stick or drop it during an attack, you already have a backup weapon with which to at least defend yourself. And if you travel with a rock tool, like an obsidian scraper or a basalt chopper, you can quickly replace your sharpened stick by making a new one on the go if you lose it during an attack. That'll do it for our beginner's combat tutorial. Thanks for watching, everybody. Leave a like and subscribe if you found these helpful. And there are more to choose from in terms of tool use and generational and evolutionary leaps. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, survivors.